Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create wall design in Revit. As you can see on my screen, there is wall design that I create one, and later on we will start to create those kind of wall here together. And of course, for instruction to create that, you need to create meshing and size. And after that, we will creating for other two components to apply those shape there. Anyway, let's stick around together for this tutorial because I will give you a quick instruction from start to finish. And I would like to ask you, and before I get this start, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, and I invite you to subscribe to my channel for learn more about Revit so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay, so let's speak into our project together. And I would like to close some window first. I will close for this guy there. I don't want to save here, and close first. Then put Control N on my keyboard for shortcut key that I prefer for metric architecture template. Then I can hit open. Okay. Alright guys, so here we are in Revit architecture template. Then I would like to close my project first, my 3D first. I would like to close this one first, just say yep. Okay, so now I want to sell file first. Let's say we first sell this one for sell. Put here for document. Where is my computer document? Make this one for cool baking design. Yep, hit okay. Okay, so now I sell my file already. It's time to create our wall design panel. So I can go to my reference plan. I need to create some reference plan first. RP for shortcut key. Then I can start pop up from here 1 and 2. Then for here I will rename this one for number 1. Hit escape. Then I don't want to wasting time to press 1 by 1. I will use array tool. Select my reference line there. AR for array, start from here. Then I will put for number 2 and move to ND for seconds, so I can control that. Move it for 4 meter and I will make it for 6. As you can see, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's perfect. And I will give for the whole dimension, DI for shortcut key. Okay, I will rescale that for 1 by 200. Hit escape. Now our reference plan all is here is mean our backing wall is 2 meter. Now I want to go to my sound elevation there. I will adjustment my level also. I can select my level 2, then click here twice. Make this one for 1.5 meter and for rename that for countertop. It's one counter top. Hit escape. Then I can create another reference plan there for top. RP for shortcut key. Okay, sorry, we are not using for reference plan. We need to create level. LL on my keyboard for level. Then I can start pop up something like this. Then hit escape. Then I will adjustment my height also. Just make this one for 6.5 meter. And level 3, I will change rename this one for top. Let's say we make it for top, hit escape. It's perfect. Now it's time to get our shape. By create our shape, we need to go to our meshing and size. Go to in plus mask there and just rename this one for mask 1. And I can simply start for reference. Make sure we give a specific a new work plan for name and change this one for reference plan. It's okay. Okay, so we take a look on our modified template reference plan there. We can drop down finding. Here is our we working on reference 1. So I can start, let's say we start for line there. Just make it straight, hit escape. Then change for reference 2, make it straight. Make sure you turn off for 3D snapping. Hit escape again. Then I can go to my reference plan to reference plan 3. And make this one using for spline. I want to make it more interesting a bit, make it like here like this. Okay, hit escape. I can go to my site plan there. I would like to close my level 1 first. Okay, 1, 2, here is number 3, is our reference 3. I can select here, then CO for copy or shortcut key. Then make sure you untick for constraint so you can move your line there, as you can see. Hit escape, then I can start select my first reference 1 and reference 2. We copy it again, then start from reference 1, untick for constraint until reference 5 and reference 6. Then I can hit escape a couple times. After I hit escape, I can go to my 3D there. As you can see, here is reference 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is perfect. I can simply select all, then create form, solid form. Then I can select the whole panel there, device surface. Make sure we edit our setting on my property. In my case, I just want for vertical only. So for view grid there, I will make it for none. Change for view grid to, let's say we make it for fixed number, and I will make a exact number 50. Okay, hit escape. Let me see first. Okay, perfect. Then I can go to select my panel there. Take a look on our small arrow down there. Because I want to open node there. Open node is okay. As you can see, now we got two node, 1 and 2. So now we know exactly what we need to create our adaptive component. I can go to my file there. New family. Then English, finding for metric generic model adaptive, double click there. Okay, so now here we are in adaptive component. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reference there. I'm using for point element. I can place for the center. Okay, hit escape first. Somewhere around there for the center one, hit escape a couple times. Then I can simply select our point there, make it an adaptive. And we need to create some rectangle on top there, but before we create that, we need to set our work plan first. I can go to set there, set, then set for vertical. As you can see, it's highlighting. And free draw there, let's say I free draw there like this, then hit escape a couple times. AL for align, I will align from point here to here, then hit lock. Then I'm going to give a dimension first, hit escape a couple times. DI for shortcut key, start from here until here, and the last guy over there, make it equal, then make here again like this, and make for high there like this. Hit escape, assign a new parameter there, new, and make this one for weeks for parameter, and make this guy for I want to delete the top one first. And I can use for arts here. Then I can lock. Okay, hit escape. DI on my keyboard for shortcut key. Hit escape. Then give this one for high for parameter. Then I can go to family tie there. Make this high there for 500 millimeter. 100 millimeter, and for width we just make it for 150 millimeter. Then I can hit apply. Okay, hit okay. Okay, perfect. Now our size is parametric, it's perfect. That would be one. Let's testing first. I want to make this one for 600 and make here for 200. Then I can hit apply. As you can see, it's parametric, it's okay. Now we need to create a new adaptive component. By creating, we need to go to new again, file, and we finding for new family. We go to our English, and we finding for our generic model adaptive again. And of course, there I will load in from family A. Okay, hit escape first because I need to place some point there first. Hit escape a couple times. Go to our reference, go to point element. Then I point set a plan, point for the center here. Hit escape, make this point element for adaptive again. And go to our create component, then I can place already, as you can see. So the way we will snapping, as you can see, hit escape a couple time. We need to copy that to create form. I can select here, simply select like this, then CO for copy. Start from here until here. Hit escape a couple time. I can select all, and then create form, solid form, and I just like the whole panel there. Let's say this one is the whole solid panel. Then I want to assign new parameter. Go to associate the element there for parametric give name for for shortcut name for material. Then I can hit okay, and of course I can testing first before I load into our project. This one is testing. Okay, it's adaptive, it's perfect. We not got any problem on our adaptive, so I can control Z a few seconds. Then we need to load into our project, load to code backing design. Okay, so I can go to my 3D there. It's time to place that. I can start place from here 1 and 2, as you can see. And of course there for our panel there, we can flip. We can select there and take a look on our property there. We can show our adaptive component. We can flip that. In case you don't know that, I just let you know. As you can see, let me flip back first. Okay, now it's time to assign a new parameter for material. I will make for material there. Let's say we make this one, create new material, rename it for wall. Then go to our apparent library. I like flooring. I will use this flooring there for texture. Okay, so we don't need to press again and again. It will be wasting our time. I think some of you know that and some of you didn't know that how to press that. So you just go to repeat tab there, it will be repeating. So now far we'll be generating. Okay, as you can see now it's repeating properly. I can hit finish. Mess. Now we got our cool looking for our wall design. Let me finish up for the reference and we will start for render together, and later on we will see together. Okay, so let me finish up first. Okay guys, so here is the final that I have arrangement for my layout there. I got my reception counter, I got people that inside one, I got some sofa there and some chair there for when customer come in and need to waiting there for meeting. Okay, so now I got render also finish up also. Let's see the render result. I don't want to wasting your time, or you want to render that, you can press RR for shortcut key for render, and you can play around with that for setting up you want to high or medium or best or render. And I this guy over there, I have render already. Let's see my final render there. Here is my final render there. I using for high. As you can see, it look quite cool for with our wall backing design using our adaptive component for complex design. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you guys for joining me from start to finish. I hope you got learn something new for adaptive component in Revit. I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.